Hello students, welcome to Python online classes. Actually in the last class we have started about the sets concept, and in the last class I have completed some portion of sets. Okay, and from that continuation part in today's session I would like to complete. Now let us start our session. Okay, using in and not in operators to test for a value. Using wait the page has moved, that's why. Sets creating set is also over. Getting a number of elements in a set is over. By using length function we can get the length of set. Adding and removing elements and updating elements also over. Now in and not in operators. So using in and not in operators to test for a value in a set. Testing methods we can use. I mean, using in and not in operators in a in sets. Okay, there are two types of operators we have, whether the item is there or not. If the set contain whatever the value we have passed, whatever the item we have element, whatever the element we have passed in the set, that element is not there or not, that element is contains the set or not, it will check by using in operator. And second operator is not in operator, that is the reverse process to second one. If the passed element is not there, not in the set or not, so that if you want to check those type of searchings, if you want to check those type of checkings, for that we can use the in and not in operators. In operator and also not in operator. Whether the element is there or not in the given set, then in operator will work. If the passed item element is there, not in the list or not, for that not in operator will work. Okay, these two are membership operators. These two are membership operators. So you can use the in operator to determine whether a value exists in a set or not. The following interactive session demonstrates nothing but some examples here I given, and for your understanding purpose I also shown with the practical way by using command prompt. So for that I am opening command prompt again. I am connecting to the Python shell window. Yes, now here I want to create one set. I want to create one set. Days. Or days is okay, na? Otherwise, student set okay. Okay. Student set I am creating. Opening bracket. And here, Pavan is one name. Second one, Raju. Third one, Ravi. Fourth one, Shankar. So now I have created with the set of four values. So student set I have created with the four names, four student names I have created. Now I want to check this is set or not. So by using type function we can see the type of the created set. So set is created. So type is showing set now. So four items, four students names I have created with the student set. Now I want to check by using in operator. I want to pass one value, I want to pass one student name, whether that name is available or not in this student existed student list. So for that we can use the in operator. So if condition I am using, if now I am passing is Hari. Hari, I want to pass. In which set I want to set? Student set. So that's why student set I am giving the information here. So again, after that, print. One indentation space is also required before giving the print function. And here, Hari is available. Hari is available. Again, else one print function. Hari is not available. So carefully observe here. Now again one more time I am printing. Hari is not available because of the student list contain Hari name. Hari student na? No. So that's why. Okay. If the Hari not there. Now I am removing this one. Instead of Hari, I am passing the Pavan because the Pavan name is there in the set. Pavan name is there in the set. Now, instead of Hari, I am passing Pavan. Next, else. Pavan is not there. Right, again one more time. Pavan is available because of Pavan is available in the given list. Already we have created set with the Pavan item, Pavan value na. So but Hari not there. So that's why the program working like that. Understand? So if you want to search any element, in the given set, for that we can use the in operator. Actually for the in operation, not in operator is also work reversely work in the in operator. Actually whatever the operation it is doing by the in operator, that complete reverse process is done by the not in operator. So for that, again notepad I am opening. Here, now I am creating one set, student set. Student equal to open bracket Pavan. Pavan is one name, Raju is one more name, Kiran is one more name. So three names I have stored in the Pavan's student set. Okay. Now not in operator example I am showing, carefully observe. For that, if condition I equal to I in, sorry, for that now I want to search whether the given number is not there in that list or not. In previously whether the element is there or not, but now by using not in operator, what is the example we have to check here? Whether whatever the element we have to pass, that element is not there in the list or not, we need to check by using not in operator. So now I want to pass Hari is the name here. Because of this name is not there in the list or not, I want to check. Okay. In which set? Student set. Reverse process. One space I want to give. Then Hari is not in the student set. Now I am closing this one. Okay. Else one colon, one print symbol, one print function. Again, Hari is available in the list. Because of if the Hari is not there, then if block will execute. If Hari is not there, else block will execute. Here in this place, not in operator we have to use. Okay. Now I am saving. Go to file menu, choose save option, notin.py, save as type is all files. Now I am exiting the Python shell window. CLS I am using. Here I want to execute, not in file. So for that CD desktop, I want to shift the location. Not in .py file is, I want to type here. Yeah, I have typed it. Now I am pressing. So Hari is not in the student set because of, in the student set, Pavan, Raju, Kiran, three names we have. Hari is not, they are not there. So that's why if block, it has executed. Okay, right. So that is the process of in and not in operators uses in the sets. Now, finding the union of sets. Actually, sets works like a mathematical sets na. Already in 10th class, we have learned about the sets concept in the mathematics. What are that? Union, intersection, so all those things. Now you got it. So here also we can use that those mathematical sets. So finding the union set, first we have to see the union of two sets is a set of set that contains all elements of both sets. The union of two sets is a set that contains all the elements of the both sets. In Python, you can call the union method to get the union of two sets. Here is the general format. Set1.union set2. We have to pass. Actually, union is also one of the method. Now, I am clear the screen. Now, again, I am connecting the Python shell window. Now, I am creating one set. Set1. Okay. Set1. Open curly brace, 1, 2, 3, 3 elements I have passed. Again, I want to create set 2. Again, flower bracket open, 4, 5, 6. Okay, in this two sets, 3 elements we have. Now, I want to create one more set 3. So, here set 1 dot union of in between functional bracket set 2, I want to pass. So, I want to combine those two sets. After combination is over, all elements can store into a set 3. Like the process is going on. Now I am pressing. Now I want to see the set 3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All elements has combined by using union method. Understand? Like that we have to use the union sets. Union of sets. And next one is, we can see, finding the intersection of sets. So the intersection of two sets, we have to use the intersection. Here set 1 contain how, what are the elements? 1, 2, 3, 4. Set 2 contains 3, 4, 5, 6 elements. Set 3 contain set 1 dot intersection of set 2. Then what are the common values we have in the two sets? That common values it will print. Now same set 1 and set 2 I have to maintain here. Set 3 equal to set 1 dot intersection method I am using. So set 2 I am passing as a parameter inside the intersection. Now I want to see the set 3. So empty set, because of common values we don't have. Set 1 contain 1, 2, 3. Set 2 contain 4, 5, 6. There is no common value. Okay, if you have any common value, then it will print like that. For your understanding purpose, I am creating one more set here. 1, 2, 3. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Three elements we have. Now set 2 equal to 2, 3. I have passed here. So now I am using set 3. Set 1 dot intersection of set 2. So here common values we have now. 2, 3 is the common value in both sets. So those two values now it will present on the screen. 2, 3 values it is showing now as a output. Because of intersection functionality is what? What are the common values we have? Those common values, it will fetch by the two sets only. Okay? And after that, it can store into a set 3. Now, we can understand now, what is the intersection, what is the union. So, like that, mathematical operations also work like that by using sets. Now, finding the difference of sets. So the difference of set 1 and set 2 is the elements that appear in a set 1 but do not appear in the set 2. So now we have to see the difference method. So actually, what is the meaning of this one? 1, 2, 3, 4 is the first set elements. And second set elements are 3, 4, 5, 6. Set 1 difference is what? 1, 2. Compared to first set, the second set contains difference is what? How can we see the difference? So the difference of set 1 and set 2 is the elements that appear in the set 1 only. So first it will give the priority to the set 1, but do not appear in the set 2. So what is the difference here? Here 3 4 3 4 is we have, but in the first set, after removing these 3 4, what are the elements we have? 1 2, because of from the set 1 we have to see the difference of set 2. Okay, so the first priority will give to the set 1. So for the difference method we can use, understand? So here set 1 is 1 2 3, set 2 is 2 3. Here if you use the difference method, the output what it will got, the output what it will get, 1 is the output, because the first set contain extra value is what? 1, the difference. Second set it will ignore by itself, but if you use the reverse process, it will show empty set. Carefully observe, set 3 equal to set 1 dot difference of set 1. Now I want to see the set 3. Set 1 dot difference of set 1, because of there is no difference, because of I have passed 2 sets. Here also I have passed set 1, here also I have passed set 1. So there is no difference, so that's why. Now I want to compare with the set 2. Now set 3 is what? 1 is the value. Now I just now I told you na, first what is the acceptor? 2 values, 2 3 2 3, common values. After that extra value is in the set 1, extra value is what? 1. So that extra value it will show the difference. Okay, second set it will ignore. If you pass the set 3, carefully observe, reversely I am passing. In the set 3, set 2 dot, not set 1, set 2 dot difference of set 1. So now I want to see set 3. There is no difference because of 2 3 values we have. 2 3 values we have. So to, after 2 3, exception of 2 3, again extra value we have in this set 2, there is no extra value. So that's why empty set it is showing for us. Now you can understand na? Right. So that is the difference. If you want to find out any difference by the sets, we can use the like that. We can use like that. So here minus operator also will work, will use the to show difference. Okay, now set 1 minus, okay, set 3 equal to set 1 minus set 2. So now I want to see set 3. 1 is showing difference now. So this is also the difference, this is also equal to difference method. Okay, minus operator also will work like that. So if you haven't used a difference function, just simply you can use the minus operator also. It is also work like a difference method. Finding the symmetric difference of sets. Symmetric difference of two sets is a set that contain the elements that are not shared by the sets. In other words, it is the elements that are in one set but not in both. For example, here we can see set 1, 1, 2, 3, 4 elements we have. Set 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 we have. Set 3 equal to set 1 dot symmetric difference, symmetric underscore difference, set 2. So set after what you will get? 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. 1, 2, 5, 6. 1, 2, 5, 6. What is the meaning of this one? I want to see the what is the difference of symmetric difference. Then we have to see the diagrams here. Then only we can understand. Adding items. Yeah. This is union diagram. This is intersection diagram. Okay. And after that, intersection update. So extra information here given. The symmetric difference of two sets is calculated by square operator. I mean, symmetric difference method. Symmetric difference of sets, it removes that element which is present in both sets. Removes the elements both in two sets. Okay. So here both sets contains what? 3, 4 elements. So that's why it has removed. Carefully observe. Symmetric difference means what are the common values we have in both sets, those common values removed by the symmetric underscore difference method. Then remaining values, what here 3-4 is common, second set is also contain 3-4. In the first set contain 1-2, second set contain 5-6. After removing 3-4 values in both sets, what are the values we have 1-2, 5-6? That 1-2, 5-6 it will represent on the screen. That is the symmetric difference. Practically I would like to show for you. Yeah, first I am creating the set 1 is equal 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so here 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 elements I have created with the set 1. Now again set 2 I am creating 3, 4, 5, 6. So I have created 3, 4, 5, 6 elements with the second set. Now I want to show the difference, symmetric difference of set 3. Set one dot symmetric underscore difference of set 2. Yeah, now the function worked properly. Now I want to see the set 3. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. Because of what are the common values we have? 3, 4, 3, 4. These 3, 4 elements in both sets, common values, whatever the common values we have, those common values have removed by the symmetric difference method. And after that, remaining values we have 1, 2, 5, 6. That values represent on the representing on the screen. That is the meaning of symmetric difference. And instead of that one, using symmetric difference, we can use like this also. Set 3 equal to set 1 and set 1, and this operator we have to use. Set 2. Square operator, that one. I mean symmetric difference operator, that one. Now we have to see what we call that one. You can also use the operator find the symmetric difference to set. Here the format expression is this one. Wait. In net we have to check what we call that one. Symbol pronunciation. Yes.
Symbol.
Symbol name, right. Circumflex. Actually this is called circumflex operator in the mathematical way. Okay, right. Simply you can use the cap symbol. Okay, so now this is the process of this one. Now I want to see the set 3 difference. Same output we got now. By using this operator also we can see the symmetric difference, right? So now this concept is also completed, finding subsets and supersets. Suppose you have two sets and one of those sets contain all of the elements of other set. Here is an example. Set 1 contain 1, 2, 3, 4. Set 2 contain 2, 3. Now what is the output we got? Is subset. Set 2 dot is subset of set 1. True. Is superset of set 2 true. What is the use of this one? Suppose you have two sets and one of those sets contains all of the elements of other set. Here is an example. Okay, here set 1 contain 1, 2, 3, 4. Set 2 contain 2, 3. these two three elements also we have na in the set one common elements we have. So that means if the common elements we have both, if the common elements we have in two sets, then it will return two, it will return true option. If not there, then it will return false. We can see that one also. Here set 1 equal to 1 2 3 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4. So these four elements we have. Set 2 contains 3 comma 4 comma 5 comma 6. Like that we have to create. Now set 3 equal to set 1 dot is subset method. Okay, is subset method we can use, is subset of set 2. Now set 3 false, it is written. Why? 1 2 3 4 3 4 5 6 common elements we have na. Set 3, why it is returning set 1 dot 1 2 3 4 set 2 dot 3 5 3 4 5 6. So common elements we have, so compulsory it will return I want to remove from here to here, then what it will show? False. Is subset, set 1 dot is subset of set 2. So the common values we have, then again what it is showing? 1 2 3 4 2 3 enter subset set 2. Okay, false, it is right answer, because of set 1 contain 1 2 3 4, set 2 contain 3 4 5 6. Am I correct or not? Carefully observe here. Here I want to compare set 1 to set 2. Set 1 contain how many elements? 1 2 3 4 4 elements we have, but set 2 elements 3 4 5 6. So here two values it has matched, all values it not matched with the set 1, so that's why it is showing false. Now set 1 equal to 1 2 3, carefully observe, 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4 I have created. Set 2 I want to create with two values, 2 comma 3 nf. Now I want to compare set 2 to set 1. Set 2 dot is subset of set 1. Now it will return false, it will return true. Yes, because of set 2 contain 2 3 values, these two values also contain set 1 also, it is also subset na, 2 3 2 3 it is also subset, so that's why it is returning false, it is returning true. So like that we have to check that is that subset or not. If you want to see superset or not, 1 2 3 4 2 3 set 2 dot is subset, set 2 dot is superset. So now the reverse process I want to see. Set 1 dot is superset of set 2. Set 2. So now it is also returning true because of superset. Thus set 1 dot is superset of set 2. Set 1 contain set 2 values na. So nothing but it is a superset of that one. So that is the meaning of this one. Nothing but is greater than or equal, is less than or equal. It is comparing to this one. Carefully observe. The set contain what? Set 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. It is the big length. 4 elements we have. Set 2 contain 2 elements. Set 2 is the subpart of set 1 or not? It is asking. It is the meaning of that one. Set 2 is a part of set 1. Yeah, 2, 3 values is a part of set 1. Na? So that's why it is returning true. And here, set 1 is superset of set 2. Nothing but set 1 contain 1, 2, 3, 4. Set 2 contain 2, 3. So for the set 2 elements, contain what? 2, 3 elements. So set 1 contain 1, 2, 3, 4. These 2 elements and also extra elements also we have. So that means it is the superset of this one. So that's why it is returning true condition. True means accepted condition. Okay. Yeah. Now we have completed sets concept. In the next class, I would like to explain with the new con. I would in the next class, I will come with the new concept. And now I am closing this session. Thank you. Thank you very much.